And as you can see, they're all nicely close together holding hands, and their hands are representing tight junctions or gates. And here is the more complicated look. So as you can see here, we've got quite a few tight junctions, and it's incredible how there's so many gates there that we still are able to open a lot of them up by some of the foods we eat. And here is leaky gut. So as you can see here, a lot of the mucus is gone and all forms of nutrients and bacteria are flowing through past the intestinal lining and into the bloodstream. Various causes can result in inflammation and increased permeability. So intestinal permeability and increase is also like leaky gut. So certain medications, antibiotics, now this is the overconsumption of them. So if you take them once, don't worry. However, overconsuming of them can result in more inflammation and intestinal permeability. Infections, injury, common food allergies, allergens, so gluten is a big one, dairy, corn, egg if you're sensitive to it. Low stomach acid, as we talked about, toxins, and then even stress. And the reason inflammation is bad is not also because it impairs the function of the gut, it also affects the quality of life. So as you can see here, we create neurotransmitters. So these are chemicals which make us feel good, give us a form of relaxation. So dopamine, serotonin, and GABA. We create 95% of serotonin in the gut. It's incredible. 50% of dopamine is produced in the gut, as well as the bacteria which are in the gut control how much is being produced. But the big thing at the bottom, as you can see here, is that when there's inflammation, it doesn't affect the quantity of these neurotransmitters, these feel-good chemicals. It affects the receptors. So the chemicals will stay in the gut, but the receptors are going to be altered, so we can't absorb them into the bloodstream. Mm. And this study was very interesting how certain very inflammatory bowel conditions have shown. So as you can see here, ulcer colitis. So this is a very aggressive form of inflammation in the colon. There's high serotonin and dopamine in the gut, but hardly any is being absorbed into the bloodstream. Anxiety. So GABA is fantastic for reducing anxiety, but if we got inflammation in the gut, then we're not absorbing that GABA, which we're producing and getting that relaxing feeling. So that explains why cannabis, when people have anxiety and they take cannabis, it's reducing inflammation, and then we're absorbing that GABA.
Amen.
So how to tighten up the gut. So as you can see here, the arrows pointing down are a good thing, and the tissue for the tissue permeability. So that means that there is the connection between the cells is very strong. So vitamin A, vitamin C, and vitamin D, fantastic for helping with that. Vitamin D is a huge one. So modulates zonulin. So when we eat gluten, it results in zonulin, this molecule, to be released, and then that results in our intestines to separate and have all forms of leaky gut going on. And vitamin D modulates that chemical or that molecule. When there's a deficiency, there's an increased risk of hospitalization and increase in inflammation in the colon for ulcer colitis. It reduces, when there's a deficiency, there's a reduced regeneration for tissue repair. As well as 50% of Americans do not get benefits from vitamin D due to a lack of magnesium levels. So yeah, there's a huge connection there. Zinc's a big one, and I'm going to be talking about later on. You can see here, flavonoids, basic things, so dark, fruits, citrus fruits, broccoli, fantastic for reducing inflammation and helping keep those intestinal cells nice and tight. Collagen is another great additive. Type 1 is the most prevalent, the most common type in the gut to help repair it. And I'm just going to go through quickly of the aminos. So, threonine. This one's not very talked about a lot, and it's very, very important for mucus production. So we're going to talk about mucus, but this one is very important as it's the component designed to help increase the production. And I'll show you later. When we talk about mucus. Lastly, as you can see here, glycine, fantastic for helping heal tissues, as well as when they induced inflammation in the colon in mice, they supplemented with glycine, they had a reduced amount of episodes of diarrhea, improvement in weight loss, reduced inflammation, as well as the ulcers were far better. Another big one right here is and tryptophan at the end. So tryptophan converts into serotonin. So again, having that amino present. At the end, I'm going to categorize everything. I know it's a lot of information. You have to think, why am I